Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about real-time PCR, which is also known as qPCR. Why it is called as qPCR? Isko qPCR kyun bolte hai? Kyunki yahi PCR is quantitative real-time PCR. So as I have written already RT-PCR and qPCR, this is real-time PCR. So we have various variants of real-time PCR which are available in the market from promotional or very big companies, what you can say. One of that is Thermo. They have ABI products, Qiagen is there, then Biomolecular Systems is there, etc. So we have a huge range. Bio-Rad is also one of that. Now, what is the advantage of real-time PCR over conventional PCR is, as we all know that conventional PCR, once you run the PCR, you have to perform the gel electrophoresis on that, and then you have to visualize the gel on a UV transillimeter or a gel documentation system. So that is a lengthy procedure and it is a time consuming procedure. Whereas in real time PCR, there is no downstreaming required. So what is the meaning of no downstreaming? That means you don't have to perform a gel electrophoresis, or you don't have to examine that particular whatever amplified product under UV light or a transilluminator. So that is an advantage, and a real time. So that means as reaction progresses, you can actually observe the fluorescence, the intensity and CT. What is the CT? We will talk about that later on. So that values you can come to know, and you can observe your real time data in, you can perform the interpretation while the reaction is going on. So you can come to know whether the reaction is positive or negative, or it is going to be positive or negative there and there itself. So you don't waste much of the time as compared to the conventional PCR. Now moving on to the chemistry of the real time PCR or a qPCR, there are two types of chemistry over there. One chemistry is a cyber green chemistry. Cyber green chemistry, it is just a double stranded DNA related chemistry. So basically your fluorescent dye gets tagged between any two double stranded DNA, and then as you melt it out during a high resolution melt curve analysis, that will give out the fluorescence and you can detect it. So that is the chemistry behind cyber green chemistry. Other chemistries are also available with respect to this dye, EVA green chemistry, and depending on various brands, they have given the various kinds of dyes with the modification of the existing cyber green chemistry. The second chemistry, which is very important and which is up to the mark and very efficient, but it is an expensive and costly affair, that is Tachman-Probe chemistry. This is a Tachman probe chemistry, and it has been extensively used for to the point detection. And how does that work actually? We will talk about that. So in case of Tachman probe chemistry, what is the principle behind that? So what happens, once your RNA gets amplified and probe anneals to a specific target sequence located between forward and reverse primers, during the extension phase of a PCR cycle, the 5' nucleus activity of your tag polymerase degrades the probe. So what exactly happens, as you can see, if there is a fluorescent and there is a quencher, during the amplification the tag polymerase degrades this and the quencher will go away. So as fluorescence quencher will go away, this will give a fluorescence signal, and this signal will be captured, and as cycle progresses, more and more signal will come into picture, and it is going beyond your detection threshold, and it will be detected, and then you will say, okay, my target is present. So that is the chemistry behind Tachman probe. Now moving on to the next part, detection. So detection, so it has a, like as I have said, there are two chemistries, cyber green chemistry as well as Tachman probe chemistries. With respect to that, whatever we have is related to our understanding. So cyber green chemistry has a huge amount of applications, and whereas Tachman probe chemistry has majority of the diagnostic related applications, in a real time PCR you have single nucleotide polymorphism application, you have high resolution melt curve application, you have genotyping, you have Tachman probe related chemistry, etc. So you can think of that. The applications are numerous, whether you are working on an infectious or a non-infectious biology. And apart from that, important point is Tachman probe chemistry. What you have fluorescence and a quencher. So what does quencher does actually, we will talk about that. Quencher absorbs the signal given by a fluorescent probe. Okay. So basically, as long as in Tachman probe chemistry, the polymerase doesn't break this particular region, and if this doesn't get broken, then you will never get a fluorescent signal. So that is the main point behind Tachman probe chemistry. So with respect to corona, I will discuss in a brief. So what exactly currently we have with respect to real-time PCR and how we can use real-time PCR for the detection. So one of the IIT Delhi institute, so that institute has produced a corona detection on a cyber green chemistry, okay. And whereas many numerous companies are there, they have produced on the basis of Tachman probe chemistry. So what is the basic funda behind the detection? So this the viral nucleocapsid gene, okay, that is the N gene, will be detected in case of corona from the sample and from a human sample, because we need to confirm that whatever sample we have taken, it is from a human origin, that is a control. RNSP gene will be detected in the same sample. So what exactly detection will occur, we will talk about that in a brief. So with respect to detection, what exactly we need to do? First of all, whatever PCR reagents we get, we need to dilute that, okay, and we need to store that. So after probe, whether it is cyber green chemistry or a Tachman probe chemistry, we need to dilute that and put that into minus 20 or a minus 70 system. Minus 70 degree Celsius fridge will be for a longer duration, obviously. Once you get the sample, what you need to do? Once you get the sample, you need to extract the RNA from the sample, and you need to extract the RNA from the control sample. Then you will need to prepare the master mix. After preparation of master mix, you will need to prepare a RT-PCR plate. So basically, majority of the time, your PCR plate will be either 96 well block, or it will be, you can say, a strip-wise manner, 8 strips or a multiple strips depending on your sample load. Then you will need to run the assay on a particular approved system, which could be a real-time PCR of any company, and then you will need to analyze the data, and finally you will report the data. So generally, what are the normal PCR steps and qPCR steps? The main difference between two, in case of normal PCR steps, again there is no Tachman probe chemistry, so you just have regular chemistry, which is not even a EVA grain chemistry or a cyber grain chemistry. You get the primers and then you dilute the primers and you use your primers for the amplification. After amplification, you run it on the gel and you observe it in the conventional UV transilluminator or the gel documentation system, and you compare that with your existing ladder, and once the ladder is confirmed with the band of an amplified product, you say that okay, this is my product of interest and the PCR has worked. This is the conventional chemistry. In case of real-time PCR, you either have a Tachman probe chemistry or a cyber green chemistry. So in case of Tachman probe chemistry, once you get that particular Tachman probe chemistry fluorescent intensity, you confirm that in a real-time PCR that particular gene of interest is present or not. Whereas in case of cyber green chemistry, you have to go ahead with the high resolution melt curve analysis, and over there during the melt curve you will come to know that depending on single peak or multiple peak, whether you have your gene of interest present or not. Now remember that multiplexing in a real time PCR is tricky and it is always going to be a little bit difficult, but if you have a knack of conventional PCR or if you have done multiplexing on a conventional PCR, then working on a real time PCR is always easy. I hope you like this video. Thank you.